Hi, it's Mary Beth Shaw. I'm here on my birthday because I wanted to hang out with you guys. And, you know, I thought I would do something that I've never, ever, 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 ever done before in public, which is name names regarding my favorite stencils. Because we're having a sale right now. You might have heard about it. It's a birthday sale. And all of the stencils are on sale. All of them are. And everybody always asks, well, what should I buy? You know, because we've got like 1,000 stencils and it's really hard to make a decision. I know that. So I thought, you know, I am going to help everybody to understand the stencils, why I use the stencils I use for the applications that I use them for. And I'm hoping that it'll help educate everyone a little bit more about stencils, and just maybe you'll want to take advantage of these fantastic sale prices and pop on over to Stencil Girl and take advantage of that. Carol Baxter's with us, so she'll put the code on here. Only people watching live and within the time frames that the code is active will be able to use the code. I know that sometimes there's people who watch it afterwards and so forth, and anyway, they wouldn't be able to watch it. But I'm having a week. My signal's popping in and out, and I don't know. It's really making me nervous. I'm looking at it, and it's making me very, very nervous. So, but I don't know what to do about that. So here we are. All right. Well, the very first thing I wanted to cover is creating backgrounds. This is one of my things that I do a lot of. And easy, I'm going to turn this down to the journal page now, and I'm going to show you examples of stuff that I do and ways that I create backgrounds. All right. So here is a previously gessoed journal page in front of us, and I'm going to give you two examples of backgrounds. One is going to be using like square formats, and one is going to be using more circular type. And I tend to go one way or the other. Hello, I'm going to say hi to the people that have popped on. Joanne and Carol and Ruth and Brenda and Carol Swan. Hi, you guys. And thank you so much for the birthday wishes. It's just lovely. Carol Baxter also put up the information regarding the sale that we have going on at Stencil Girl Products. Okay, so backgrounds. If I'm going to be using a like a square type format, what I'm going to do is basically layer up a bunch of square patterned stencils. I'm going to use my smudgy and I'm going to work fast. This is a Michelle Ward. S is in Sam, 189 is the number. I love this stencil. I use it for so much. Here's the reason why. One, it feels very like architectural to me, which I adore, and that makes sense because you know what? I believe Michelle studied to be an architect back in the day before she became a genius artist and designer of stencils and rubber stamps and all things fabulous. But look how cool that is. This is a great stencil for backgrounds and also for doodling. Hey, Mary Nasser and Deborah Gable and Andrew Borlos. Hi, you guys. When I'm making papers, I move the stencils. I move them around like this. So we're just going to pretend that I'm making a background or making papers. So this would be my first pass with a square format stencil, all right? And then we'll put it to the side. Let's find another one. This is Carolyn Duby, S is in Sam, 191. Beautiful stencil. And it exploits some different square looking pieces. This is what I think makes art interesting, is when you layer, 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 layer. And this is, my stencil's stuck to my page. Come on, baby. There it is. So already you can see we're getting a lot of interest here. Here is one of Andrew's stencils that I like a lot. This is S is in Sam 028. I've used this stencil a lot. I love it because you can create these little compartments and then you can move them around you can connect them. They remind me of little almost Tetris parts. Remember the game back in the day? I used to love that game, Tetris. So I love this stencil for creating the addition of that sort of thing. These are my own, my grids. And I tell ya, these babies almost just rock by themselves. It's a set of grids where you get all three of the grids and you can just go around and make grids till your heart's content on top of one another. You can make big, you can make medium. And you can see I'm staying analogous with the color. I'm pouncing. And Suno, I'm back. I am back indeed. I couldn't stay away. And then go to the smaller grid on top of that even. Exploiting lights and darks. Continuing to move. I hope I'm making this seem easy because it is easy when you have the right tools on hand. And that's what I want to teach everybody. So that's why I'm here. This is a very fun stencil by Daniela Wolf. S is in Sam 322. I'm going to pull a little black in here so we can get some contrast and a little bit of a darker contrast. These squares are in a slightly different orientation. They're going to be dancing around the page. And this is a new stencil that has just become a real fave of mine. Love! Isn't that cool? So, and then last but certainly not least, I love this Carolyn Doobie stencil. This is L381. And look what you get with this. You get two sizes of squares. So you can put one size up here. And then you can lay out these right on top of them and make them another color. So you have squares in squares, on squares, around squares. Is anybody tired of squares yet? Not me. I love the squares. So that's just an example of how I would do a quick page with squares, wherein I named names regarding some square stencils. So voila. And Eva is commenting and Brenda's saying amazing depth with the layers. Thank you, Brenda. That's exactly what I was going for. And I think I just did it in a couple of minutes. So that's how I would create a quick, easy, square-based background. Now, I'm going to pop on over to this page, which is a smaller page, and we're going to do some circles on this one. And I'm going to start out with another Michelle Ward stencil. This is L235. Look at these babies. Now, they are even bigger than my page in this particular instance, but you know what? I don't care. I still like it. And I just flipped to the other side of my smudgy. I'll have one for my blues and one for my pinks and reds. This, again, I gessoed before we came on. I don't use the whole stencil. Get it, move it. Curvy Lattice. See this stencil? This is one of my designs that I love. It's, this is an old baby. L020. You know what that means? It was the 20th stencil that the company had. Isn't that crazy? But see how the lines are and there's so much open space. That means you're going to get a lot of paint going on in the background. And when I'm trying to create layered looking pages, paint is what I want to get down quickly. So I will look for a stencil with a lot of open spaces. Lori is asking a great question. What's the purpose of using gesso? The reason I use the gesso, Lori, is because often in later layers, I want to move back down, and I can do that with the gesso, like with a baby wipe. Well, I had my baby wipes right here. Here they are. I'll show you a little baby wipe technique since we're playing today. We'll put this stencil right here. This is another one of my stencils that I like, and this is S006. So for 6x6s, this was our sixth stencil. So I'm going to lay it right down here, and I've got my baby wipe in my hand. So instead of putting paint down, I'm going to pull paint up. And Lori, I hope I'm blowing your mind, because this is one of my very favorite techniques. And you wouldn't be able to do that without the gesso. See how you can get that removal process. If you did not, the gesso is like a kind of a primer for the page. So it allows you to have a lot of flexibility with removal of your colors and moving your colors around. Things you couldn't do if it weren't there. So that's the main reason I use it, because I just never know exactly where I'm going to be going in the future, and I have these options. It also lets me get a little bit beefier with what I put. Oh, Lori, mind blown. Oh, good. I'm so happy. I love that. Eva wants to know if I could show how I use the tile stencils in my journal. I will. And then here, lastly, is the last little circle one I love. This is a Carolyn Doobie also. It's L380, and there's circles and circles. Once again, working exactly like they did, the squares did, in that you could put them down real quick, and then, where did that white go? I'm gonna pop a little white on here, or a little lighter anyway. And then I'm going to move this over top of them. And it's so easy to see where they go. Super easy. And then boom, you've got your dots on dots. So voila, we've quickly created a circular page. Now, let's say you want to use circles and squares together. I have three stencils that are faves of mine. This is a new stencil by, new-ish, it's S314 by Terry Stegmiller. Look at this puppy. Could that be any more beautiful? It kind of looks spiderwebby, but it looks, I don't know what it looks like. I just love it. And it's a very great stencil for if you have elements that are organic, but they are also organic, meaning like circular and fluid, but they are also organized and somewhat square-like. This is a great stencil that will just hop in here and look lovely with both of those qualities, organic and linear and organized at the same time. This is another stencil that I love for that quality, and I'm going to go back to the blue page and add it to the blue page. This is, I don't know, one of you peeps like Carol or Mary or is Lisa Dobrion here. I don't know what the number is on this, but I love this stencil. It's really cool. I've been using it a lot lately. Again, it links up to me the linear and the more organic elements into one look, and it's really nice to kind of use that. Because look at that, how it automatically gave, hey, Harriet Reese from Chicago and Nancy Curry. Yay, 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 yay. Can we order the finger sponges? Yeah, the smudgies, we do sell the smudgies. We can't give a discount on them, Deborah, but do throw them into your order, because I'm telling you, you're gonna love them. And they wash up like nobody's business. And lastly, Daniela Wolf again, S372. Love, 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 love this stencil. You are gonna dig this one. This has the squares and the circles again. And I'll have to say, Daniela Wolf, you know, it's just like sometimes that girl, she like crawls in my head and knows what it is that I want. And I don't know how she does that, but she does. So I'll give you, I didn't use a very good color on that. Let me see if I can get some white out here and I'll try to lighten that up and give you a better look at it. Let's see if I can get a lighter look over here. Basically what you've got though is you've got the circles and the squares and the lines all going on in one stencil, and it is so cool. So here's how that looks on top of the other layers, and I think it's kind of rocking. I really do. All right, so that was your very, very quick tutorial on backgrounds and painted papers. Now, art journaling, which, oh my goodness, you guys have heard me talk about this so much, but I did name names today. And let's see, goodness gracious, if I can find any places in my art journal to put any additional stuff, it'll be a miracle. Generally speaking, for your art journals, you want stencils that are gonna be a little bit smaller, because if you're working in a book, you don't want these huge. I mean, this is a 9x12 book, and so a 9x12 stencil works beautifully for it. But if you're in a smaller book like this one, you want to keep it a little bit smaller, and you'll find it lines up on your pages better. They also work for travel quite well. And I'm going to switch over, since I'm not trying to cover a whole page, I'm going to switch over now to one of these little soft sponges. And I'm just pouncing on some black with my soft sponge. And I'm going to start out with an oldie but a goodie. This is a Pam Carricker M026. I'm teaching with Pam. I'm meeting her out in California in a couple days. This is kind of like, you might think, well, it's kind of like sequin waste. And it kind of is, but it's not. It's like a messy sequin waste. Thank you, Mary. She likes the seeker spread. It's like a messy sequin waste because they're all like broken circles and so forth. And I've always loved that little guy, and I carry it with me a lot. Just like I love that there's a bigger version of it too, where you could use the smaller and the bigger together. And I often carry these with me when I travel. Look how this is intentionally, it's got that intentional rip at the side. Love, 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 love. And triangles, anyone? Let's add some triangles down here, because this is a Ray Missigman stencil. Ray is just a world-class art journaler, and almost all of her stencils are designed with that in mind. But this little triangle is a favorite of mine, just a favorite. And speaking of faves, this is another Ray, this repetition stencil. I am so obsessed with this stencil. It's almost ridiculous. You could probably find one in my purse. I mean, I'm exaggerating, but I carry it around with me everywhere. It just adds that little, you know, it's just, it reminds me of that French phrase, je ne sais quoi, I don't know what, just a little bit of something, something. That's kind of about the end of my French right there. You heard it here first. And it just is just such a nice little thing. Karen Lee just called me a nutball. Oh, so also art journaling, Seth After, this Inside Out stencil. This is one of my faves, and here's why. Because you get this row of circles that I use on everything. You get the number 4, 5, 6, which I don't know why, but I love that. You get a big old X, you get inside and out, another X, you get this linear part, you get enter, secret. I mean, Seth's stencils are fantastic for journals. Which one are you talking about, Joanne? This one? I bet she's talking about this one. This was a Stencil Club stencil that I designed, oh my gosh, a while back. I don't even know when. This is a Seth After right here from one of his journal pencils, or one of his journal stencils. Yeah, I like that one a lot. But his are great. And Mary Nasser, who's right here with us, check out all the arrows. She's got two arrow stencils. The other one has curving arrows, but I really like this one, especially with those two dartboard stencils of mine that just came out. These are so cool, and you can just do a lot with them. Love them. And then finally, my hash mark stencil. It's just one of my faves. So that is your very, very quick art journal rundown. Now, next, this is a category near and dear to my heart, integration stencils. Because I get people asking me all the time about, you know, well, how do you make the pages hang together? And I'm trying to find some that, Hashmark love, Kristen Reese Williams. I know it. Me too. I just love that. And you guys all know I trim off one row. So I just have one row that's by itself that I use all the time. Love that. Let's find some pages that need integration, shall we? These have got so much going on. Goodness. Let's see here. This doesn't have much going on, but it doesn't need to be integrated yet. You thought I might have picked some pages before I came, or before I came on the air. All right, now this is very angular, this page right here. And let's get a little white and see if we can't do some integrating of this. Integrating is, and I don't think this is the right stencil for this page. I'm going to use this stencil of Daniela Wolf's called Succulents. This is probably my number one, maybe number one or two favorite integration stencil. What I mean is we've got squares of things here. There's a bunch of different sections. There's this number. And what I want to do is try to pull them all together, okay? Hey, Annalie, pretty name. So I'm going to pounce and get some more white paint, and then I'm going to go across here in an integration effort. This stencil is so tight that you can almost go sideways on it because not a lot is going to go wrong. I got a little wet there with it. My gesso's kind of wet. I think I maybe didn't shake it up or something. But you can see that kind of integrates this and prevents it from being so geometric. And that's the purpose of a good integration stencil. It would be impossible to integrate this page, just saying. Too much going on there, too much. This could use some integration right in here. We'll use a little bit of black for that. And I'm gonna use this stencil of Maria McGuire's, this S264. I adore this stencil. I'm going around some of the words, and I'm actually going to take it down and off the page. See how beautiful it looks on there? Karen Talbot says, you must have missed us. I did miss you guys, right? So I'm going to take some up here in the corner, like I often do, the opposing corner of the page. And I think that has kind of put a little framework around here. Great integration stencil. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So Succulents. And then this one of mine, this is one of my Makes Marks pipette stencil. This is a fantastic integrator, as well as these Celtic knots of June Daly's S233. I adore this stencil. And funny enough, this stencil didn't even really come into my frame of reference until, I don't know, long after June designed it. I don't know where I was. It's like sometimes they come out so fast, I don't get to use them. Let's put a little bit of this down here. Again, this is a stencil that you can go sideways with it. Such a nice, crisp design. And look at the pattern on that baby. I mean, is that ever gorgeous? The Celtic knots, it's just one that I reach for over and over again. And again, I don't want anybody, I hope none of my designers are in here feeling bad if their stencils aren't picked, because I love all of our stencils or they wouldn't be part of our repertoire. But to see, you know, the ones I use in my work sometimes helps people to make decisions, because I know it's hard. We've got 1,000 stencils. Yeah. We are just a little bit nuts here, a stencil girl. You knew that though, right? Okay, so those are the integrators. Then, are you new to Stencil Girl? Are you new to Stencil Girl and you don't have any stencils and you don't know where to start? This is a question I'm frequently asked. What on earth do you do? Well, Maria McGuire is to the rescue because she has designed two fantastic stencils for people new to Stencil Girl products. And these are these Doodle stencils. I think it's called Doodle It and Doodle It Larger, if I'm not mistaken. S266 and L347. I adore these stencils. Carol Baxter, I like being nuts. Yeah, that's why Carol fits in so well with us. And the nice thing about these is you get so many designs in every stencil. And all you need to do is tape it off with like that painter's tape that doesn't stick a lot, or even just put a post-it note over a part, and you get all these little component parts. Look at the little borders you can get out of this thing. I mean, because you get a little square border here, you get a little round border here, you get a little row of zigzag here, you get a row of, what are those called? Scallops there. I mean, seriously, it's a checkerboard. It's this, it's that. I mean, it's just perfection, perfection. And this big one is the same thing. You get four fantastic borders. 1, 2, 3, 4. This right here, I use so much that it's pretty ridiculous. Anyway, they're fantastic stencils. Thanks, Maria. And I would be remiss if I didn't say something about this one of Tracy Bautista's. This is L311, and I adore this stencil. I use the same parts of it over and over. I use these three flowers, these two right here, and then this one. Because they're these dense, they come out dense, solid color flowers, and they are just so beautiful. And again, I tape off and use this little linear part here. I use this part here. These over here, these round parts. This is an amazing stencil that I use all the time. This could be a great journal stencil as well. It's got tons of little journal components if you look up close here. It's just, it's a stencil that I have had people come to me and say, I want to buy one stencil. And I will say, you know, I will ask the person first what they're drawn to. And if I find out that they're a person who really adores flowers, this is almost always the way I will, direct them. Karen Lee says she loves Tracy's. She uses hers and Seth's the most. I can believe that, Karen. Seriously, I use Seth's quite a lot because I like graffiti-looking work, too. And last but certainly not least, Aiden's school. These little fish. I don't know if you know the story, but my grandson designed this stencil when he was 8 years old. And we have almost 50 designers today. and training them to draw stencils that don't fall apart, that are bridged properly so that they're stable, can be a challenge. And we end up doing a lot of work behind the scenes sometimes. And Aiden, age 8, designed this. It did not require one edit from us. It was perfectly bridged. And we just laughed out loud, and we pay him royalties just like we pay all of our other designers. Of course, I don't think it's going to put him through college or anything, but it's still a pretty cool thing knowing that he has created a stencil that has become a part of our business. So that is my little birthday faves presentation for the day. Does anybody have any more questions for me before I get out of here? If you do have questions, just pop them up on the comments later, and I'll try to jump in and answer them. I hope I helped you think of different ways to use stencils, or different ways to consider a stencil for a particular use. Happy everybody. I just love all the love I've gotten today. It's just made me feel so nice. What kind of cake am I having? I don't know. John and I have been so busy with the sale. I just don't know what we're doing. We're probably going to have carry out for dinner the rate it's going. Thanks you guys so much. I appreciate all the love. It just means the world to me. Thanks so much. See you again soon. Bye-bye.